featuring Ogden Area Collectives, Pando Art Collective, OMOCA, and the Bob Ross Society. An exhibit that brings together artists from in real life collectives in response to the zeitgeist of growing apathy, loss of personal connections, cancel culture, and cyber posturing on the internet that's leaking into academic spheres and leading to echo chambers of stupidity being only accessible through social media. Contemporary collectivity, what does that mean? So, here is our online exhibit. This painting by Lindsay Huss, a member of the Pando Art Collective up in Ogden, is titled American Toxic. Now a member of the Bob Ross Society. Next is a series of comics by Celtic Fox, talking about the dependence of our culture on our phones. This one is Back in GPS. Multitasking in reality. Cinema with friends. No one came to the wake. Match magnet, finding the perfect match. Trust versus copy breaks. Miscommunication. My favorites. And the urinal. Jumping back to the Pando Art Collective, this is a painting by Sarah Gao called All Hands on Memes. It is acrylic on masonite. This piece called Mind Vomit is by Allison Neville. It is 14 years worth of doodles that she did while trying to maintain an active sketch practice. Ali is also the founder of Bob Ross Society. And, of course, Chris McFinn. We recently got married. That's the first mushroom she ever sketched. And I love me some narwhals. And here we have a little sketch of a cockroach trying to drag a cigarette into the sewer. This small piece is called Words of Wisdom in Times of Peril, and it is 6 blank Chinese scrolls. Jumping back to the Pando Art Collective, we have Michelle Larson. These are a collection of collages. Which are rather brilliant, if not disturbing. And the companion pieces that go with them. This is Creamsicle. Miracle Gel and Ultimate Moisture System. These are actually oil paintings of the collages. Absolutely amazing. Here's our first piece from OMOCA, which is the Ogden Museum of Contemporary Art, founded in 2015, I think, by Laura McCallister-McNair and Jay Bjorkes. This is Laura's work, which is a second iteration of her temporary shelters, which she did last year in the Battle for Bigs Art Center. Cool. And ideally, if people were able to walk in here and walk under the umbrellas, we would have dry erase markers for them to be able to write little stories that they tell themselves to make themselves feel better, or things that they rely on in order to keep them above water. It's a really fun piece to be inside, which makes it all the more frustrating that it can only be viewed online at this point. But we are hoping that if we extend the show through May, we may be able to do a closing show. But we're not going to deliver it. Unless somebody's coughing near us. Also from the Pando Art Collective is Chris Bodley. He does all of his work freehand with ink on paper. There is no pencil beforehand. and the kind of psychological studies, and his artist statement is embedded in this particular one. At least I believe it's his artist statement. I wanted to create something beautiful, but I wonder if the hours of work will seem pedestrian once I'm finished. The word art doesn't mean anything to me. I don't see myself as an artist and don't need the world to see me as one. But still I draw. I speak in the language of line, ink, on paper. Can you understand what I'm saying? Can you see me in these lines? Can I see myself? Now co-founder of OMOCA, Jake Yorquez, with his installation piece, You're in It Together with All of Us. Sorry, Jake kills me. It's all about how we are all the same, so basic. Because we all are so relieved when we finally get to relieve ourselves. Unfortunately, the earth, one of the aftershocks, not the first earthquake, but one of the aftershocks later, caused it to leak. Finally, this is my video piece. 8 hours and 3.5 minutes. And I belong to all four of the collectives. I belong to the Downtown Artist Collective, OMOCA, Pando Art Collective, and the Bob Ross Society. This was shot from my dashboard with... This is my day as a carpool mom. And I try to balance being an artist and a mom and having 5 kids attending 5 different schools while also being a student in a long-distance residency program at the School of the Artists of Chicago. You're watching this on my YouTube channel as we speak, so you should be able to find any of my other videos there. And as this fades out, I just want to thank everybody for taking a minute to watch. I realize that it's difficult to really comprehend the nature of these pieces without being there in person. A lot of it is lost in translation, which is the entire point of the show. How much we lose when we're not interacting with each other. that the purpose of a collective is to share ideas and broaden each other's minds, to avoid the echo chambers, to challenge each other. And I hope that everybody will take a moment to challenge themselves with something they've seen here, or challenge one of our artists. Ask us some questions. Make it hard. Let us expand our own vision. I'm Katie Mr. Strader, and I appreciate so much the work of the LSC. Even though we knew this show was not going to open physically, they followed through and continued to show up. They suited up, they showed up, and they delivered in the room, and I'm so grateful. And thank you to the Downtown Artist Collective for hosting us, and particularly to Jamie Kyle for all of her hard work in helping with the installation, and Desiree E. with her online work,